Hey everyone, welcome back. All right, today for our session, you're gonna need your yoga mat. You're going to need a pad for your knee, maybe a foam roller or a medicine ball or a water bottle, something like that to support yourself when we go into our couch stretch. And seeing that we're doing a couch stretch, you're gonna need a wall or your couch. All right, let's get started. We're gonna start in a child's pose with shoulders today. So we're gonna sit back on the heels, spread the knees out wide. We're gonna walk the hands out forward, inch the hands out as far as you can. Then we're bending the elbows, bringing the hands behind the neck, and we're gonna hold here for 1 minute. Come on up. We're gonna move to a thread the needle. So we're gonna come up off of our heels. We're gonna reach the right arm under. So we're threading through. We're gonna turn the palm down. Reach across, drop that right shoulder to the ground. And we're trying to reach our left shoulder down to the ground as well to improve that stretch. Okay, so we're gonna go 1 minute hold here. All right, come on up. We're gonna switch sides. Thread the left arm through, palm down. Drop the shoulder. We got 1 minute here. Come on up. We're gonna move to a downward dog with rotations. So let's get into the downward dog. So feet about hip width apart, drive the heels down, push the hips back. We're gonna take the right hand, reaching across to the outside of the left leg. So remember, if you have trouble getting there, you can go a little bit wider with your feet to help out with that. But find a good spot where it's good for you. We're gonna pull and rotate. We're gonna hold for 30 seconds.
and switch sides. And we're going to switch again. Another 30 seconds here. And one more switch. Alright, come on up. We're going to move to a standing straddle. So wide legs. And we're leaning forward into this stretch. Okay, so find a comfortable spot where you feel like your feet are secure and not going to slide out from under you. Okay, really grip into the sides of your feet. And get as low into this as you can. If you need to brace yourself on something, go ahead and grab that. But we're going to hold here for 2 minutes. On up. We're going to make our way down to the ground. And we're going to move into a seated twist. So we're going to hook our right leg under. Left leg is going to come up over the top. If you can't get around your knee, that's okay. You can come right in front of it. If you need to support underneath your butt cheek, support your hip with some rolled up towels or blankets or a pillow. All right, let yourself settle in, and then we're gonna bring our right elbow to the outside of that left knee, bring our chest up nice and tall, and rotate. All right, we're gonna hold here for 1 minute. right, let's switch sides. So hook the left leg under, right leg over the top, let the hips settle in. Left elbow to the outside of that right knee, chest tall and rotate, 1 minute hold. Okay, we're gonna move to a fragging. So go ahead and grab a pad for your knee. We're gonna start with the left leg on the pad. My right leg is gonna come out to the side. Okay, we want this back leg to be kickstanded. So our right leg should be rotated out and our left leg should be the opposite direction. Okay, from here, we're gonna hinge forward. We're gonna come in at the angle. Bring our elbows down to the ground, let the hips kind of settle in here, and we're going to hold for 2 minutes. Come on up. We're going to switch sides. Let's go ahead and shift your pad over to the other side. Right knee on the pad. Left knee angled out. Okay, we're shooting the angle. And we're going 2 minutes hold. Okay, come on up.
All right, we're gonna move into our final stretch. We're moving to our couch stretch. So go ahead and get to your wall or your couch. Bringing our pad all the way to the wall. We're gonna start with the right leg back. So we're bringing that shin all the way flush up to the wall or the couch. So we wanna make sure there's no gap. Bring that knee all the way into the wall. And from here, if this is enough stretch, we're staying here. Otherwise, we're trying to bring that left leg up in front and getting ourselves upright. So if you need your water bottle or your foam roller, whatever you're using to brace yourself so you can relax into this stretch a little bit, go ahead and grab that too. Remember, we wanna make sure that we're not overextending our spine. We wanna keep that rib cage down and we're only bringing ourselves up as far as we can maintain that hollow position there. Okay, so we're gonna hold here for 2 minutes. As you ease into the stretch, feel free to come up higher or adjust. Okay, carefully come on out of that and let's switch sides. So left leg all the way flush up against the wall. If we can, we're bringing up that right leg. Remember, both sides might not be the same. Okay, so one might be a little tighter than the other. That's okay. All right, but find your position and we're holding for another 2 minutes.
carefully come on out of that stretch. And we're gonna make our way down to the ground for our rebound. So go ahead and lay down. Just let yourself relax, get comfortable. Focus on taking some nice deep breaths. Just taking some inventory of your body and just being aware of what we just did and the feelings that it created. We'll hang out here for about 2 minutes. Okay, when you feel ready, go ahead and roll to your side and make your way up to a seated position. All right, that's all for today. Thank you for joining me, and we'll see you next time.